mate? My friend he is. Good morning everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn them notifications on. So, back today, and what an interesting week we have just had on the farm here. I say it's been interesting, it's been pretty rubbish. We've had crap weather, we had this happen yesterday. Now I took a video of this on my phone, so you'll have to bear with what the quality is like, but just take a look. What I want to be doing on an afternoon like this afternoon, but cows have their ways. Back in now, but as you can see, they're wearing some lovely muddy socks. This is a good cow to show it on because she's white. Yep. The earth had come off the electric, so there was no electric in the wire. One's knocked into it and decided they'd toss the rest of them out. Milking tonight is going to be a joy. So yeah, the cows got out yesterday. Me and Dad were sat in the house just having a cup of tea before milking, and I looked across the field and I just saw something moving the other side of the hedge, and I was like, oh, the cows are out. They were only out for around about 5 to 10 minutes, so it wasn't too bad, but my God, was milking fun last night. I had to wash all their feet, all the bags. It took about 2 hours when it usually takes me an hour, but anyway, that's done. Today we are not really doing anything special. I've got a few jobs lined up, but the first job on the agenda today is to litter all the cattle we've got. First of all, Mark's just getting the JCB, so we're going to put a few bales of litter around, so let's do that. So there's the bale stack we're fetching the bales out of today. That's all wheat straw. Now I've got hay, wheat and barley under the barn there, but at the moment we're using up the wheat. We've got another stack around by the cow yard, but it's almost a case of use what's outside first and then go inside. There's the first bale going in. What we tend to do with these bulls, they're a little bit on the nasty side. Well, they're not nasty, but they just get a little bit excited when putting the bales in. So we just chuck the bale in the shed, roll it over, and they'll sort it out themselves. They're pretty good at doing that. Saves us going in there and potentially getting hurt. So this is the shed with our dry cows in it. This will be bedded down with barley straw. Now we use barley straw for two reasons. One, because they're under the barn, they're dry bales. The last thing you want to be doing with dry cows, especially close to calving, is putting wet straw underneath them, because that is just encouraging bacteria to grow, and then as a result of that, you get mastitis. Not good. And the other reason, it's a lot better for bedding down. It lasts a lot longer and it's better straw. So we tend to use that with the dry cows here and the younger stock around the other side. Here comes one of the broken barley bales. Yeah, and just a quick one actually. We seem to struggle a lot with rats getting in our barley bales here. They seem to always get in there, they're chewing the wrap off, and you end up with lots of loose bales. Just a question for anyone that's watching, have you got any advice on how to stop them doing it? Because I tell you, it's a massive pain keeping barley straw here and you end up with just loads and loads of loose bales. So drop it down in the comment section below if anyone watching knows how to remedy this problem. There we are, there's the littering done. On to the next job, is to sort the silage sheet out. Friday today, and everyone knows that there is nothing more annoying than on a Saturday or Sunday morning, you gotta start moving stuff to feed the cattle. You want the jobs to be as quick and as easy on the weekends as possible. We're gonna jump up there. We've already moved a row of bales over the course of the week. We'll just talk about that a little bit more once we're up there. So all I've got to do, cut the silage sheet, remove a few tires on the end, and then there's that job done. So we're up on the silage sheet now, and as you will see, we have got bales up here. We had a bit of a discussion at the beginning of this year after we'd finished, well, last year now, once we'd finished the silage, and it was almost, what are we going to do with the top of the silage sheet? Now, we don't have enough tires here to cover the sheet where all the tires are touching. So we always ended up with a lack of compaction on the top, which results in waste. So I decided to suggest the idea of putting round bales up here. Now, again, it's great storage. It's dry in here, so you get more bales under cover, and also you get rid of the problem of having waste on top of the silage. So these are actually bales from the 2018 harvest. They were left in the barn when we come and finish doing the second cut silage. So we already had the bales available. Now, if we'd had to have waited for the harvest, it probably wouldn't have been an option because the sheet needs to go on as soon as possible. And we finish our harvesting silage, that is, at the end of June. So you're almost looking another month before you have any bales. But luckily we had some. So we'll just peel the sheet back and we'll have a look at the top of the silage because the result does not disappoint. First of all, we'll just get these round. They're obviously round because if you had a square tire, they would be no use. We'll just throw the tires down onto the floor there, just stack them up in that corner. As you'll see, the sides have actually dropped away a little bit now. That is because you can't actually get perfect compaction right against the sides. Also, there's air creeps in from the side. Now, we have got sheets going up the side, but they have got worn out over the years. We tend not to put new sheets up every year because it just basically costs too much money. So we do get a little bit of waste down by the sides here, but it's not a lot. Now, just ignore the bit of straw that's on top of the silage here, but if I just take a little bit of this, I don't know how well you can see that on the camera. Let's try and push it out of the light. You can see that there's no black waste on the top of this silage, which means all of this silage can be fed to the cows, which is brilliant. You get no waste, basically meaning haven't lost money. So the bale idea has worked really well. That's all really to look at, to be honest. It does look a bit dark, but when you're actually seeing it in person, is a lot better. Like, you can just tell there's no slimy waste. That is all good feed that can go to the cows. It's quite wet out there. And there we are, there's that job done. It doesn't take too long and it just makes your life a little bit easier on the weekends. So the other thing I forgot to mention, where the bales are concerned, they are perfect for the straw chopper. Usually what we'd have to do, go around the other side, fetch bales around, but they're readily available here. So if the straw chopper runs out when you're just doing the one side of the cubicles and you need some more straw for the other side, you can put a bale in nice and easily without having to go through the cows. And here is just a quick look at the face of the silage pit. Now, as you'll see, you can just about see where the tines go in a little bit. But if we just have a look over here, there's hardly any wastage on the front. And the best silage face is compact silage. The more compact that silage is, the better clean face you will get. And it just shows, because we do our own silage, the loads aren't coming in anywhere near as quick as a contractor would. That is as hard as a brick wall. And that is one of the biggest plus sides we have, along with the weather and everything, of doing our own silage. It gets better compaction. We've got the JCB, which is a heavier machine than the tractors, rolling it down as well. And we always spend a lot of time rolling the pit. So when the silage is coming in, there'll be breaks between loads where you can roll it. And then also mornings and nights, we spend about an hour each side of the day rolling the pit again, just maximizing the compaction. There we are, there's that video done. And I think that brings us to the end of today's video, guys. Can't really think of anything else we've got to do. Pushing now on towards 4 o'clock, so time to mill. So I'd like to thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next one.